Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Artichoke Music for our Thursday Night Coffeehouse Showcase. Tonight, we have three wonderful acts for you. First up, Patrick TOVATT. And I'm going to quote from him. He says, if you're going to shoot off your mouth, you might as well say something you believe. And so he's had a career of 50 years on the stage and television, film, including several Broadway runs and an Emmy nomination. Patrick returns to his roots as a folkie. He writes his own material, usually pungent, sometimes funny, always opinionated. Please welcome to our stage, Patrick TOVATT.
Wow, that was a great intro. I might have thought I wrote it myself. I'm going to talk for 2 minutes. Valiant few. Artichoke is very dear to me. I started coming here in about 2008 at the old place on Hawthorne and playing the Friday night coffee houses. I would drive up from Southern Oregon, where I had relocated after I retired from the theater in New York City. And the essence of that experience was community. And perhaps you're wondering why I'm dressed in bib overalls, and I've reclaimed the native and traditional dress of the elders of my tribe. My tribe, the agriculturalists of the West. I grew up in Colorado. I'm a Colorado native. And the two counties where I spent most of my childhood, or all my childhood, were Gunnison County and Otero County, one on the mountain in the mountains of the Western Slope and one out in the flatlands of the Arkansas Valley in the High Plains. And those two counties, when I lived there, had a combined population of about 10,000 people, and they are slightly smaller than Delaware and Rhode Island combined. So I recognize my agricultural forebears by dressing this way because we shared a community that was tight and was very important to everybody who was in it. We recognized each other. If I saw somebody in a suit, I knew they belonged to the town tribe. And if I saw somebody in bib overalls, I knew they belonged to my tribe, and I knew how to behave. It was a social signal that I was responsive to. And this current society has lost a great amount of that social integument, the sort of glue that holds us all together. And I blame three factors. One is the hyper-individualism of American society and economy, the social isolation that the digital age has promoted and exploited, and it wasn't helped by the pandemic. And we all got used to kind of being isolated. Which brings me to Artichoke. This is really, really, really important that we keep Artichoke going. And I know that I'm speaking to the choir because here you are. Yeah, valiant few. But it's really, really, really important. We recognize each other. We need to support each other, and we need to be together. Now, more perhaps than at any time in my long, long life. Okay, they say advice to writers are that you should write what you know. So this song is about being old. Old man in a boat, just glad to float. and stout enough to wrestle with regret. Resting on the oars, 'cause his lower back is sore, lets the river take him where it goes. There's an ache down near his heart, where he picks his life apart. It swells or wanes, but rarely fades. He wasted precious days parsing how it played. Too late to fix those failures anyhow. He knows he could have lived it better, or for sure a whole lot worse. But maybes just can't matter to him now. So loafing in the sun, sturdy skiff to run, blunts the fear that life is slipping by. And that ache down near his heart, been with him from the start, he'd miss it if it ever went away. Just an old man in a boat, glad to be afloat, no particular place he's gotta go. His lower back is sore, so resting on the oars, lets the river take him where it goes. Just lets the river take him where it goes. Lets the river take him where it goes. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, just so that I wouldn't deprive you of my opinionated stuff, this is called The Wheels of Justice. Just because I'm a lefty, that doesn't mean I'm soft on crime. Perfectly okay with Trump and his flunkies doing time. I'm for prosecuting all the felons right up that insurrection chain. Give those lackeys in the U.S. Congress tickets on an outbound plane. Now that search down in Mar-a-Lago sure tied his undies in a bunch. The FBI found a lot of stuff. They had more than just a hunch. Now it occurs to me that his loyalty may be less than meets the eye. So he might wind up in Leavenworth or Moscow on the fly. But his crime up in Bergdorf Goodman, that's the frosting on the cake. E. Jean threw down a slam dunk right in the rapist's face, and the jury didn't dawdle, sitting on their butts. They hit Trump in the wallet instead of kicking him in the unmentionable. Man's a one-man crime wave. Now it seems like the wheels of justice are turning kind of slow. Blind justice is digging a mountain of shit, and she's still got a long way to go. But if you do the crime, you gotta do the time. That's American as apple pie. And that's why the prison business is the only growth stock to buy. So yank the gangsters off of K Street and into Slam, where they belong. Let the scales of justice weigh them. Let's hear them sing those convict songs. 'Cause I'm a patriotic, country-loving lefty, you bet your ass. But I damn sure know that the rule of law means nobody gets a pass. Now this rant's gone on long enough. I'm gonna bring it to a close. Put your shoulder to that wheel of justice. Don't just take the hose. Patriotic, country-loving Americans, heed the call. You can't spectate, you gotta participate, and you keep your eyes upon the ball. All right, now, we're experiencing a crisis that is not unprecedented. There have been other times in American history, like the Great Depression and the earlier depression of the 1870s, which almost is never covered in American history, but we had two massive not only depressions, but rendings of our social fabric in the 1870s and in the 1930s, from the 29 on. But right now, the current houseless crisis is not being handled very well. This is about a young houseless boy. It's called Billy Waits. Billy curls deeper in his ratty sleeping bag, wearing all the clothing that he owns. Wet, rotting sneakers won't dry out in the cold. He drags them up beside him through the mold. 28 and terrified, living on concrete, Billy waits for fate to call his number. If only he was clean, if he only had love, if he only had a roof above his head, if he wasn't always hungry, if he wasn't wet and cold, if he didn't fight the dread, he'll die alone. Gunshots down the block, he'll sleep but never slumber as Billy waits for fate to call his number. Billy knows he's screwed and he hates himself for that. Shaking in his rage, he starts to laugh until the twitch begins underneath his skin. He'll crawl out through the night to steal again. City fathers stall, yell, we can't save them all, while Billy waits for fate to call his number. Angry voices scream, demands to sweep us clean, to satisfy the housed and amply fed. Too much of everything leaves not enough for Bill, and will not put a roof above his head. Tired of the crime, the feces on the streets, the engine of the state begins to lumber. Through commission and report, the politicians sport an unforgiving street called Billy's number. No policy will save him in his cardboard grave. Billy finally rests. Not in slumber. The history of folk music is, as one wag has commented, just one damn theft after another. So if you're going to steal, you better steal from somebody who's better than you are. So this is a nod to Brownie McGee. I just got tired of running around. Finally got sober and turned around. 'Cause that old nightlife, that old sporting life was killing me. The old folks tried to talk to me, so headstrong and foolish I couldn't see. All my life I've been laughing, now I'm the old folks and the joke's on me. I get emails about my home. More folks that knew me back then are dead and gone. It'll make you wonder, it'll make you worry about what's to come. Took me a long time to change my ways as I grew older with each and every day. When I was a young man, oh, it was so easy to go astray. At last, I saw the light. Now I stay home most every night. Don't need to worry or say I'm sorry for what I've said or done. I won't tell you wisdom comes with age. Took some hard knocks to calm my rage and write love in the book of living. On every page to write love in the book of living. On every page to write love in the book of living. On every page. Okay, this one's back when the before the pandemic, we had a fairly severe disruption in our economy. The 2008, the Great Recession, they called it. It was almost a depression, but it was not quite because the Wall Street made. made out okay, and investors made out okay because they were buying up stocks at bargain basement prices, and they came out of it very, very, very well. However, it was the signal that started what we call the gig economy, and people being subcontractors and working two and three jobs just to make ends meet. And this is called Living on Part-Time. This is about the gig economy and what it's done to America. Living on part-time, scuffling full-time, eating fine sometimes. Can't spare a single dime. On the TV, they're buying cars and drinking beer. One thing I know for sure, lucky suckers don't live here. I'm a working man of the steady kind with a strong back and a willing mind. I thought I lived in the USA and prosperity was here to stay. At night my wife sobs, we're both working three jobs. Met her at the picture show. Where did that dream go? Somehow I missed that trip. Just hope that I don't get sick. Gotta make my daily grind, or I'm gonna be left behind. Well, I'm a working man of the steady kind with a strong back and a willing mind. I thought I lived in the USA. I'll give you all I've got for a fair day's pay. No time to fix the bathroom leak. I hardly saw my kids this week. Bald tires on a car won't start. I'm in a slow motion fall apart. Panhandlers on the freeway ramp. Kent City is a homeless camp. Cold dread has me by the throat. One stumble and that's all she wrote. I'm a working man of a steady kind with a strong back and a willing mind. I thought I lived in the USA. Won't you please tell me where I lost my way? I'm no use for politics. Den of thieves playing money tricks. Who cares what they say will pass? Cause all they're gonna do is kick my ass. Keep trucking cause I won't give up. My wife and babies to a bacon cup. I'm chained to a life of hawk. Bootstrapping is a total crock. Well, I'm a working man of the steady kind with a strong back and a willing mind. I thought I lived in the USA and I am not sure we're gonna be okay if I can't make the rent. Be lucky if I find a tent. Every time I hear American Dream, I wanna punch a wall and scream. Living on part-time, scuffling full-time, eating fine sometime, can't spare a single dime. Well, I'm a working man of the steady kind with a strong back and a willing mind. I thought I lived in the USA, but I am barely making it day by day. Thank you. Okay. This is one of the first. I didn't start writing songs till about 2007. I wrote a lot of other stuff before that, plays and things like that, even a soap opera. What do you think of that? Soap opera set in France on the Riviera. I wrote it in upstate New York. I had guidebooks and maps of the perfume country in my office, and I was reading biographies of Princess Grace and books like Perfume and things like that, writing this crazy nonsense that was being shot in Paris. This is the world we're living in. No one makes a killing off a piece. Race and religion are the grease that will guarantee the slaughters never cease. 'Cause no one makes a killing off a piece. No one makes a profit when you're well. We fix the price of everything we sell. So if you can't pay the doctor, go to hell. 'Cause no one makes a profit when you're well. We see periodic efforts to reform all this, to make the world a kinder, juster place. But as long as we're in charge, we'll go on living large, bringing down our boots upon your face. If you're ignorant, you're easier to fool. If you're zealous, you're quite the perfect tool. If you're zealous and you're ignorant, you're fuel. That's why we've cut the budget to the school. It's our God-given right to raise the rent. If you can't pay the landlord, get a tent. Did you think a living wage was heaven sent? Our charitable urge just came and went. We see periodic efforts to reform all this, to make the world a kinder, juster place. But as long as we're in charge, we'll go on living large, bringing down our boots upon your face. If you want to get elected, tell a lie. Almost anything you fabricate will fly. But you got to make it big to qualify. So go on, tell a whopper, don't be shy. Politics is simpler than snot. Politics has only got one plot. What they tell you is exactly what it's not. And a law will never pass that isn't bought. No one makes a killing off a piece. Race and religion are the grease that will guarantee the slaughters never cease. 'Cause no one makes a killing off a piece. No one makes a killing off a piece. No one makes a killing off a piece.
Ah. You valiant few. Wonderful. I don't usually do covers, but there are some a comic valve, safety valves that you sort of need, and this is one. As I'm gonna put it up here. As I sat down one evening, 'twas in a small cafe, a 40-year-old waitress to me these words did say. I see you are a logger, not just a common bum. 'Cause nobody but a logger stirs his coffee with his thumb. I had a logger lover, there's none like him today. If you poured whiskey on it, he would eat a bale of hay. He never shaved the whiskers from off his horny hide. He drove them in with a hammer, and he bit 'em off inside. My lover came to see me, 'twas on a winter's day. He held me in a fond embrace that broke three vertebrae. He kissed me when he left me, so hard it broke my jaw. I could not speak to tell him he forgot his Mackinac. The
weather tried to freeze him. It tried its level best at 100 degrees below zero. He buttoned up his vest. It froze clear through to China. It froze to the stars above. And would you, at 1,000 degrees below zero, it froze my longer love. They tried in vain to thaw him. And would you believe it, sir? They made him into axe blades to chop the Douglas fir. And so I lost my lover. And to this cafe I've come, awaiting for some logger like you to stir coffee with his thumb. That was a purportedly written by the agent, the press agent for the Northwest Loggers Association, who, in association with a guy who owned a cafe in Seattle, wrote this about the great North Woods and logging and all this. The only unfortunate thing is that an earlier edition of this tune was collected by somebody in Wisconsin, and they traced it basically back to another tune, a similar tune that was hatched in New Brunswick and Maine. So there are three great North Woods in the American history. We had the great North Woods of the Northeast and Eastern Canada, then the great North Woods of Minnesota and Wisconsin and Western Ontario, and then the great North Woods of British Columbia and Washington and Oregon. So that song made it all the way through, and the first time it was copyrighted was in the third, in its third incarnation. Okay, this is, what's our time, by the way? Another song about the El Camino Real, the King's Highway, was laid out when California was still Spain. And it's been in constant use since the Spanish colonial period, as the connection between the all the settlements and the religious communities that were all over California. And right now it goes right straight through Santa Clara Valley, which is the richest valley per capita on the planet. There are more billionaires in Santa Clara Valley, which includes Silicon Valley, of course, than anywhere on Earth. And a friend of mine was down in California going to a benefit for homeless women in a shelter in Palo Alto, and heard this phrase, Hotel 22. And when finally asked, what is this Hotel 22? They said, well, it's the 22 bus on the El Camino Real. That's the only safe place for the day. So we go there and we ride it all day long. It's called Hotel 22. Margaret lugs her bags aboard and sags into a seat, breathing through the pain in her arthritic knees and feet, praying that her lunch bag holds enough to see her through 12 hours on El Camino in Hotel 22. Palo Alto, El Camino, Santa Clara, Hollenbeck, Alameda, King and Story, Alamarock to Eastbridge Loop, in the Santa Clara Valley, what's a homeless gal to do? when the only place she's safe is riding Hotel 22. Margaret, one of millions, sleeping rough and cast aside, who survived despite misfortune, shattered hopes, wounded pride, rousted from the shelter, grabs her life and makes her run, pays the fare, greets the driver, rides until the setting sun. Palo Alto, El Camino, Santa Clara, Hall and Beck, Alameda, King and Story, Alum Rock to Eastridge Loop, in the Santa Clara Valley, what's a homeless gal to do when the only place she's safe is Dryden Hotel 22? Defending all she owns in three splitting garbage bags, Margaret mulls the many blows that tore her life to rags. In the world's richest valley, can you possibly explain why women ride on public buses to escape the winter rain? They roll through California, mothers, sisters, daughters, wives, sleeping rough in dirty weather, tattered clothes, blighted lives. In the world's richest valley, can you possibly explain why women ride on public buses to be free of fear and pain? Palo Alto, El Camino, Santa Clara, Hall and Beck, Alameda, King and Story, Alum Rock to Eastridge Loop. All right, now, yes.
Can you give us one more?
One more. Yes, and I'm gonna devolve into nonsense. How about that? This is a song that I wrote in 1922. Well, I'm almost that old. This is called the Talking Tune Wrecker. What'll I do when the sun comes down? Scratch my chin, grin round. Dance like a goat, put on my hat and go downtown. Dance like a goat in a wedding gown. One foot on top of the other. Whoa, Nellie, play another tune. That Nobel Prize better get here soon. Well, I left my youth at the county fair. Now I'm tied to a rocking chair. Cards were dealt, I drew to a pair. You'll never get a ticket if you ride Shank's mare. Sidewalks are rife with signs. Takes shoe leather to hold the line. You want to give the gift that costs nothing and always a hit? Back scratch. Augustina Hippo was an African. Jesus was a Jew. Country clubs for them, far between and few. Now old Augustine was a man of color, said sin's a sermon and a razor's duller. Just war in the morning, just war at night, just kill them till they pray and come round right. Now even to my untutored intellect, that suggests difficulty, purely as a practical matter. Now I'm old as a pratfall, funny as steers, I learned to limbo under the ears, but backsliding has stripped my gears, and nothing's as good as it first appears. Piano in the river, fish in a tree, take no advice from a fella like me. 'Cause I swung for the fences, whiffed and fanned, and I'll ride the pine if there's afterland. Play me a song when I fold this hand, my good ear's ripe for a big brass band. She gave me a map to a place unknown on my way old dog on a bone. You gotta organize. You gotta organize. You gotta organize your nonsense. Play me a song when I fold this hand. Play me a slow one, that'll be grand. Play me a song, can I hold your hand? Play me a slow one, that'll be grand. Play me a slow one, that'll be grand. Thank you.
Thank you, Patrick.
You are few, but you are mighty.
Thank you, Patrick.
Oh, you're so welcome.
All right. Good stuff.
And if anybody wants a mandolin, right over there are two handmade mandolins. One made by Mike Dulac, who is in Rocheport, Missouri. It's made out of Missouri walnut and Sitka spruce. Very fine craftsmanship. Very simple but elegant mandolin, and I know it's a good mandolin because his wife is best friends with my ex-wife. And the other mandolin is by a guy named Evans, and he is in Queensland, Australia, and it's made out of all Queensland or Australian woods, and very fine craftsmanship as well. It's much fancier mandolin, but those are two mandolins that you want to have if you need a mandolin.
And those will be in our store here at Artichoke Music, right? Okay.
Yes, I'm donating them to Artichoke Music, and they will be in the music store. I would estimate the Big Muddy, the Mike Dulac, is probably should be about $400, and the other one should be around 1,000.
Wow. Well, thank you so much for your donation, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for Patrick Tovatt. Okay, give us a moment, and we'll set up our next group. Hang with us.
Okay.
Need to get the little stand.
Oh, yeah, okay.
You guys about there?
Yeah, we're just about.
Okay, I think we're there.
Cindy Walker. Cindy Walker.
Okay. Okay, here we go. I've known these folks for a while, old Betty and Gerson. I've known them for many years, They performed on our stage several times, many times. I don't know how you categorize it, but they've been around a while. Bellows and Squawk, they have a unique interpretation of neglected gems, if you want to call it that, from the American Songbook. These artistic influences include Irving Berlin, Mickey Katz, Clark Terry, Count Basie, Ethel Merman, Sophie Tucker, Burt Williams, George Burns, and Gracie Allen, my goodness. Despite their profound respect and reverence for songwriters, they sometimes do have been known to take liberties with a lyric or two. So please welcome Bellows and Squawk.
Thank you.
Thank you. So our first song is by Cindy Walker, and I think it's her most existential song. Now I've got to find that thingamajig. I've got to have it to fix my rig. Ain't no bigger than a bug is big. What did I do with that thingamajig?
Is it square?
No, it isn't square.
Does it flare?
No, it doesn't flare. It ain't square, it don't flare. It ain't shaped like a pear. It's just a little old thingamajig.
Is it round?
No, it isn't round.
Is it brown?
No, it isn't brown. It ain't round, it ain't brown. It don't make any sound. It's just a little old thingamajig. It's just a doodad with a thingamabobadoomafidget that you twist like a knob. Or whatchamacallit fastened down with a spring. It's just a little old thingamajig.
Is it flat?
No, it isn't flat.
Like a mat.
No, not like a mat. It ain't flat like a mat. It's no bigger than that. It's just a little old thingamajig. She swim if you can, and they swim and they swim right over the dam.
Is it stone?
No, it isn't stone.
Does it groan?
No, it doesn't groan. It ain't stone, it don't groan. It ain't button or bone.
It's just a little old thingamajig.
It's just a doodad with a thingamabobadoomafidget that you twist like a knob. Or whatchamacallit fastened down with a spring. It's just a little old thingamajig.
Is it tin?
No, it isn't tin.
Does it spin?
No, it doesn't spin. It ain't tin.
It don't spin, but if you were my friend,
please help me find that thingamajig.
Here it is.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Do you want to introduce our next song?
Oh, yeah. So our next song is by Leonard Cohen. And I saw an interview with him that said that this song was inspired by pictures of people being led to the ovens in the death camps by other prisoners who were playing string quartets and string trios and were forced to, you know, play music as they led people there. Anyway, I know that's kind of depressing, but that's the way it is. Okay.
Let me think about what key this is in. No, it's in this key.
It's in G minor, yes.
Dance me to your beauty with a burning violin. Dance me through the panic till I'm gathered safely in. Lift me with an olive branch, be my homeward dove. Dance me to the end of love. Dance me to the end of love. Let me see your beauty when the witnesses are gone. Let me see you moving like they do in Babylon. Show me slowly what I only know the limits of, and dance me to the end of. Dance me to the end of love. Dance me to the wedding now. Dance me on and on. Dance me very tenderly and dance me very long. We're both of us beneath our love. Both of us above. And dance me to the end of love.
To the children who are asking to be born. Dance me through the curtains that our kisses have outworn. Raise a tent of shelter now, though every thread is worn. Dance me to the end of love. Dance me.
Safely in, touch me with your naked hand, touch me with your glove, but dance me to the end of love. Dance me to the end of love. Dance me to the end of very much, and thanks for coming out tonight.
Yeah, thank you. Next we have our own original song, The True Story of How We Met.
Well, truth is relative. Be the way we met.
pergola. Have you met Miss Boer? Someone said as we shook hands. Or maybe in a vestibule. Yes, but there were questions in the eyes of other dancers.
Not a pergola or a vestibule. What's the matter with you? Such a silly fool. However we met, you ain't said it yet.
Is where we met. It was meant to be that we would sing a duet high up on a bluff. I hear it yet.
Sorrento, up on a bluff. Who knows where you come up with this stuff? I really think that you're all wet.
In a hotel in Panajachel, we danced in a palapa on the lawn. In Chichicastenango, one night we danced a tango until the light of dawn.
It's really anybody's guess how I put up with such foolishness. But what can you do now that we have?
Play a kazoo. Now that we have never feel blue. Now that we have met, we'll go on meeting.
Thank you.
Thanks. Okay, another original song, which I'm going to do by myself. And I want to sit down for this one, which involves lowering this mic a little bit. About there. I think that'll work. This one is called Secrets. Gary, am I close enough to this mic?
You're fine.
Okay. Still on that other song. Wait a minute. They had a secret, a love that they shared. Two drifters off to see the world. They broke all the rules in a time gone by. Everyone was chasing prestige and success, all in denial that we'll all end up dead. But they knew their love was short. For just an hour, they could be somebody else. Box lunch for two in their cozy motel. With their deception, just the two of them, secrets out in plain sight. What were they after? Around the next bend, over for the rainbow somewhere. What do they care what anyone else will think? For just an hour, they could be somebody else. Box lunch for two in their cozy motel. With their deception, just the two of them, secrets out in plain sight. What were they after around the next bend? Over the rainbow somewhere, what do they care what anyone else will think? Thank you. Next. A song that Sholem Secunda wrote for a Yiddish theater production in 1933, which became a sort of an underground jazz standard. And it became the Andrews Sisters' first and greatest hit in 1938, I think Christmas of, or maybe 37. Anyway, by Mirbis Duchesne. Of all the girls I've known, and I've known some, until I first met you, I was lonesome. And when you came in sight, dear, my heart grew light, and this old world seemed new to me. You're really swell, I have to admit you, deserve expressions that really fit you. And so I've racked my brain trying to explain all the things that you do to me.
By Mirbis Duchesne, please let me explain. By Mirbis Duchesne means that you're grand. By Mirbis Duchesne, again I'll explain. It means you're the fairest in the land. I could say Bella, Bella, even say Wunderbar. Each language only helps me tell you how grand you are. I've tried to explain by Mirbis Duchesne. So kiss me and say you understand. Please let me explain. By Mirbis Duchesne means that you're grand. my mere bestishain. Again I'll explain, it means you're the fairest in the land. I could say never water each evening say each language only helps me tell ya how grand you are. I've tried to explain that, so kiss me and say you understand. So kiss me.
Thank you.
Thanks. Okay, another original song, My Funeral. We like to keep things cheerful here. Okay?
Okay.
On a funeral that everyone remembers better than anyone remembers me. I want reporters and photographers and a eulogy by Beyonce. I want a funeral like Princess Diana's with millions of views on TikTok. If I can't have a funeral like that, I don't want to die at all. But you know, even if I'd made billions in Silicon Valley or won a Nobel Prize for my songs, that's not what I'd want them to say about me when I'm gone. I'd want them to say he was gentle and kind and generous to all. When he walked in the room, you just felt good. That's what I'd want if only it were true. In the late 1960s, early 70s, when rock music was king, there was an eccentric Portland musician who played acoustic blues, ragtime, and psychedelic jug band music. His name was John Hendricks. A remarkable musician outside of the commercial mainstream and pretty much off the grid. Never drove a car, never had a day job. He always dressed in black and wore a monocle, and he talked like a 19th century novel, an outlier even in the counterculture. When John died of a heart attack at age 34, all the hippie counterculture theater people and musicians attended his funeral. Holy modal rounders, pH factor jug band, storefront theater, names that no one recognizes anymore. There were four women in the front row wearing black, dabbing their eyes behind black veils, competing to be the grieving widow. I want a funeral with heads of state and lots of movie stars flying in on private jets. I want to fly in state in Graceland and charge admission to view my body. I want a funeral like Princess Diana's with millions of views on TikTok. If I can't have a funeral like that, I don't want to die at all. But you know, even if I had made billions in Silicon Valley or won a Nobel Prize for my songs, that's not what I'd want them to say about me when I'm gone. I'd want them to say he was gentle and kind and generous to all. When he walked in the room, you just felt good.
That's what I'd want if only it were true. That's what I'd want if only it were true. Thanks. What do we got next? Oh, we just couldn't say goodbye.
Oh, yeah. And this song, who did we learn this song? We learned it from Becky Kilgore.
No, we didn't learn this at Becky Kilgore. We learned this at PSGW from...
From Becky.
Nope. It was a couple that sang it, and I said I wanted the sheet music.
Yeah. Okay.
And then I nagged them till she gave it to me.
It was in Becky's class, though.
We took Becky's class, yeah.
Yeah, they sang it. Okay. Anyway.
Oh, okay. What key is this one in?
People in love are funny, mighty hard to explain. 1 minute they quarrel, then they're back together again.
Take our case, for instance. We had a little fuss. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, here's what happened to us.
We thought that love was over, that we were really through.
I said I didn't love her, that we'd begin anew.
And you can all believe us, we sure intended to, but we just couldn't say goodbye. The chair and then the sofa, they broke right down and cried.
The curtain started waving for me to come inside. We tell you confidentially, the tears were hard to hide, and we just couldn't say goodbye. The clock was striking 12 o'clock. It smiled at us below.
With folded hands, it seemed to say, we'll miss you if you go.
So I went back and kissed her, and when I turned around,
the room was singing love songs and dancing up and down.
And now we're both so happy, because at last we found that we just couldn't say goodbye.
We thought that love was over, that we were really through.
I said I didn't love her, that we'd begin anew.
And you can all believe us, we sure intended to, but we just couldn't say goodbye.
The chair and then the sofa, they broke right down and cried. The curtain started waving for me to come inside.
We tell you confidentially, the tears were hard to hide,
and we just couldn't say goodbye. The clock was striking 12 o'clock. It smiled at us below.
With folded hands, it seemed to say...
So I went back and kissed her, and when I turned around, the room was singing love songs and dancing up and down. And now we're both so happy, because at last we found that we just couldn't say. We tried so hard to say.
I wanted to, but he wouldn't.
Say goodbye.
How are we doing for time?
One more.
Well, you know what I have to do.
Where's my pants?
We have to
okay.
Do where's my pants.
Well, when I was in junior high school orchestra, we played a song called the song from Moulin Rouge. I didn't know what Moulin Rouge was or where the song came from, but then later on, as a middle-aged person, I heard Mickey Katz sing a song called "Where Is My Pants," and I recognized the melody, and I thought, how did he get from Moulin Rouge to "Where Is My Pants"? It seemed like totally abstract. Turned out
The song from Moulin Rouge was from the 1954 movie Moulin Rouge by George Orrick, and that song was then made into a popular song with a lyric, "Where Is Your Heart?" So Mickey Katz did a parody of it. How does this start? I forgot my little introduction. We now take you into the domestic life of an average couple. Wherever I look, I'm worried and far blonzed. My bathrobe is here, but where is my pants? The closet is full with ties and pajamas. My cufflinks are there, but where is my pants? It's a hard thing to realize that you don't put things on a place. I could wear a fancy coat, but without pants been a disgrace. I found my galoshes and a package of matzos. It's my sugar, don't make sense. Oy, where is my pants?
Your breakfast I'm making, the blintzes I'm baking, is ready, the latkes.
Where is mine, gotkes?
Please come to the table, I'll make lox and bagel. We'll make with romance.
Where is my pants?
It's a hard thing to realize that you are such a little shook. How can I love a yokel who lost his pants right off the hook? You'd better mock schnell, the breakfast is burning. I'll make for you poison.
Where is mine poison? Jockey shorts, oy, that's too flimsy. I'm liable to catch a cold. I think I'll call up Dr. Kinsey. I could think I remember it happened last September. Oy, honey, don't be breakus. I left my pants in Las Vegas. Thank you all for listening.
Thank you very much, Bellows and Squawk. Okay, give us a couple of minutes and we'll be back with our final performer. Okay, welcome back. Wrapping it up tonight is a member of the Artichoke family, actually. KATY is a longtime solo project. She calls herself KATY and the NULL Sets, and I hope she'll explain that a little better later. And it's a longtime solo project of KATY's. She's a vocalist and a songwriter of Portland's disco group Foam Boy. The project has been taking many forms over the years since its inception in 2015. KATY and the NULL Sets has been a solo singer-songwriter act, a collection of iPhones, voice memos, and elaborate synth pop albums, a ukulele drummer two-piece band, and now a new wave-inspired four-piece band of jazz musicians. The unifying element over the years has been KATY's melodies, lyricism, and the unique song forms, which borrows from the bossa nova, neo-soul, mid-2000s indie rock, and modern Americana. And one other thing, KATY is here the first Wednesday of every month hosting our teen open mic. So that's pretty good, and it's a more very successful. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Artichoke stage, KATY.
Thanks, Gary. Yes, I'm just going to start playing, but I'll tell you all the open questions will be addressed later. Dang, sounds like I'm under a pillow. Okay, that's all right. This song's called I Talk Too Much.
I need your approval, but I'll never tell you that. The same height we see eye to eye, only half the time. I've got a wolf pack, but I'm stressing over one dog. I've got too much of it, you want none of it, sorry. Electricity, haven't seen it in months, feeling it every day from behind your closed door. Maybe they all hate me. Secretly, they bring buffers to bars with me. And they never tell me it's just as well. I can watch shows in bed till I forget who I am. Energy, I've got too much of it. You want none of it, sorry.
Thank you. So, yeah, I'll address KATY the NULL Sets. I have a difficult last name. It looks really scary when it's spelled out. And my dad is also a musician, and he solves the issue by going by Guitar Bob. He's just the only one, the only Bob who plays guitar in Monterey, California. So the Null set is a mathematical concept. It is the set that contains nothing. It's meaningless, basically, but it is just a way for me to have a solo project. It basically means KATY and the nothing. Kind of complicates things when you then actually have a band. Then it's like, that's weird. The implications are odd. But anyway, that's what KATY and the Null sets means. I haven't been performing solo for quite some time. I actually am playing with bands a lot more than I ever have. So this is kind of like a return to form to be here tonight. The next song I'm playing, I need a pick. I'm going to play a couple covers tonight because covers are good for you. This one is called Redshift, and it's by an artist called Darwin Dees. And he's just the master of extended metaphor. So this is like about like physics, but also love, you know?
Spiral galaxies would turn in your eyes when I came by with a small surprise. You loved all of my little quirks, so what went wrong? Don't super string me along, come on. Was there a big bang that I just missed? Some explosion caused shift, 'cause you're moving away from me, and what did I do? The universe is mostly empty space without you. Just say which way you like me most. I can be an experiment in your bedroom lab to figure out the light we had went bad. Was there a big bang that I just missed? Some explosion caused a redshift, 'cause you're moving. What did I do? The universe is mostly empty space without you. I'll build a collider and smash us to bits to see what's inside us and see if we stick. 'Cause I will try anything this side of the Milky Way to figure out why. Drifting away. Was there a big bang that I somehow missed? Some explosion caused a redshift, 'cause you're moving away from me. What did I do? The universe is mostly empty space without you.
Dude, I love that song so much. Sorry, I have to. The you know how capos are. Fine. All right, I'm gonna play some stuff I don't normally play. This song I wrote in 2013, which was when I started writing music, when I was 16 years old. So it has like a different vibe. At the time, I was a lot more abstract with what I wrote, because I was kind of too afraid of my own feelings to really commit to writing songs about my feelings. That's how it feels to be 16 years old, but I actually think this song holds up. It's about feeling less cool than your boyfriend. And it's just a bunch of 7 chords.
Spend together. It takes 2 tries to tell you a coveted observation. You don't seem to mind quite like I do. I guess it's boring.
I'm not texting. My set list is on my phone. It'd be kind of wild if I was texting, though. This next song, I never play live because it's a huge bummer. So get ready for that.
Describe a past life, a girl you used to flirt with. yourself. Here we sit on my kitchen floor. I wish I were closer to you. Push my luck until you back away. Push my luck until you back away. Every night I write it out, a conversation. I can't bring myself to start. You must know how I feel already. From the way I lock eyes with you, little gifts, how I remember things you need. Push my luck until you back away. Push my
Wow, thank you. You know what I mean? Yeah. This is kind of the right place to go, like really go there. Like a bar, it's like, I've been, I played a set once at a McMinimins in Salem, Oregon, and for some reason they gave me 3 hours, and like maybe 20 minutes in, a bartender came up to me and was like, "The wailing is a bit much." And I was like, "I'm wailing? Oh, oh my God." I mean, that's code for turn down, which is like less painful than like cutting than being told that you're wailing. But anyway, I guess the patrons of McMinimins didn't really want the bummers, which is fair. Also at the time, I like didn't realize how ubiquitous McMinimins was because there aren't that many in Salem. But turns out they're like basically Applebee's, you know? Anyway, not related to anything. Here's my newest song, which is also a bummer.
Made the drive to a past home, guys, it's been long enough. But I was looking over my shoulder the whole time I was there. I still saw your yellow t-shirt in the bathroom line. I still saw your bicycle rounding the corner, and I was scared. Like, what would we say? What could you possibly say to me? What would we say? What could you possibly say? You didn't have the decency to never speak my name. I heard through an old friend you have a high opinion of me now. She thought she was doing me a solid when she brought you up. But if this third hand hearsay is a secret open door to talk, like what would we say? What could you possibly say to me? What would you say? In what world is that good for me? What would I say? What could possibly change things? What would I say?
Now I'm texting my friend. Just kidding. Okay, I'm going to lighten things up. Don't worry. This is a song I play with my band pretty regularly. I have to tune again. This guy does not really like to stay in tune. This song is like, it's called Last Time / Next Time, and it's about starting a new relationship and being like, this time it's different, right? No, it's not. But it like feels like maybe this time it's like gonna go better, but it's not better. It's kind of the same. Let me make sure I have my effects good.
Let's go harder. Let's go crazy.
Okay. Nice. All right.
Brush my outline. Am I hungry or queasy? I estimate the way this might end. Your hand on the tip of my neck. Should I be fearing for my life? Trust can't be built in a week. Still I try. So easy, but I said that last time. No problems, but I guess there's next time. There's always next time. Between the late nights, and then I'm late for my classes. It's like no one's here to regulate my schedule. Oh my God, what's stopping us from marrying tomorrow? Or when the hydrangeas are blue again next year? Or when our shadows are longer? If we're both still here. Just easy, and I didn't mean it
last time. No problems, but I guess there's next time. There's always next time. To want things or give out extra feelings. Well, it's too late for me now. Oh, 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 oh.
Okay. Okay. I have a bummer, another bummer, but then I have a solidly medium feel song, and then and then I get to go into open G, so even if it's a bummer, it's like, we're in open G, so it's fine. You know what I mean? Okay, this song is inspired by a songwriter friend of mine. His name is Sam. He goes by Salmon Doza. His full name is first name Sam, last name Mendoza, but his artist name is Salmon, like the fish, Doza. I think it's great. He is so awesome, and his songwriting is amazing, and his recent EP just inspired this one. And yeah, it's just another bummer. I'm sorry. There we go.
Winter comes every year. Still, each time it takes me by surprise. I know it's been a while, but the ache of missing you keeps me inside. We could have been more than just friends. I think we were a troublemaker, catching the hint that I'm a dupe, a sucker easy to fool. Could you have been so comfortable with letting the impossible play out? Was it part of a plan to cut the ties just to watch me fall? I eat dinner in the dark and turn the heaters all the way up. And wait for the desire to write to you and should I pretend you're dead? We could have been more than just friends, I think. But you were a troublemaker, catching the hint that I'm a dupe. We were more than just friends, I know. You spend your whole life around me, just like I did with you, happier with you.
We're going to gradually go to open G. First, we're going to go to drop D. I'm just announcing my tunings to you as if you, now you know. This is another song I play with my band pretty regularly. It is an extended metaphor about the pool and swimming. I picked up swimming, like lap swimming, as an adult when I was in grad school. Because, I don't know, when I was being an art kid growing up, I didn't let myself do sports because there's that like really intense rivalry and this sense of, self-righteousness being a theater kid, being like, sports? No. Gross, bad, but like maybe sports are actually fine. As an adult, I'm trying to ease my way back into that side of humanity. But this is inspired by the fact that no matter how good you shower after your swim, you're gonna smell like chlorine. Right? Or am I missing something?
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to G. When I discovered this tuning, I mean, I guess it sounds kind of basic, but it just does something different than open D. I love all God's children. Like, I love open D, but open G just, that low, it's just good. It's just got something else going on. But yeah, don't tell any of the other tunings. I teach guitar also, and try and convince younger students, like, it's okay to, like, put your guitar in a different tuning. Like, there's a lot of fear with beginner students, like, are you sure? Because you feel like you're breaking it, and it's kind of one of my favorite things is to be like, no, you can actually, like, you can just make it sound like a completely different instrument, and it's awesome. I wrote this one in 2015, and it's about, it's speculating about all of the different possible outcomes with a relationship that I was in. My high school boyfriend and I had, like, broken up and then gotten back together in that first summer of after my first year in college. Classic situation. It was very messy, very fun, but this song is about, like, in my eyes, all of the possible outcomes and my desire for that relationship to last forever, with also the reality of, like, knowing, even in my 19-year-old brain, that it was probably not gonna last.
To be out alone. You see my growing concern, and we try our best to discuss it, but we ruin it all and make out on the couch. Oh, but you know things change, and I love to stay the same. I'd still wait it out for you. See you when I never see you. longer see you. When I never see you, when I never see you.
That's it. It's 9 o'clock. Thanks for having me. Oh, I'm going to plug my teen open mic. I didn't mention it. Did I? I don't think I mentioned it. I started running a teen open mic here at Artichoke. I floated the idea to Shelly, and she was like, yes. Like, her eyebrows shot up. She was like, we need to do that. So I run a teen open mic here. It's on the first Wednesday of every month, and it is for, like, young adult performers, like, teen performers, but anyone is welcome in the audience, and I would highly recommend coming because teens are, like, kind of, like, on a different plane. Like, they're just doing different stuff, and it is, like, so magical to watch. So I'm very grateful to Artichoke Music for letting me host it, and if you need to connect with the youth and maybe feel really old, then come out, and I'd love to see you there. Thanks for having me, everybody.
Thank you, KATY. Thanks, everyone. Thanks, everyone, for coming out. Tomorrow night here on stage, it's First Friday Blues with Lloyd Jones and his special guest, Norman Sylvester. If you're looking for someone doing a great Friday night, come on by and see us again. Thank you all for watching.